Hello all, welcome back to Edumon tutorial series. This video is the continuation of the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture we have learned till the characteristics of DC shunt generator. So now we will study the characteristics of DC compound generator. As you see here, this DC compound generator has both series and shunt excitations, okay? As you see here, this shunt winding can be connected in two ways. If you connect it across the armature only, then that is the short shunt connection, which we denoted by capital S. And if you connect this shunt winding across both the armature and as well as the series field, then we call it as the long shunt connection, and which we denote with the symbol capital G. Okay, and this graph shows the characteristics of the DC compound generator. And moreover, this compound generator can be either cumulatively compounded or differentially compounded. But the differentially compounded generator, it is rarely used in practice. So we will study about the cumulative one. So the characteristics of DC cumulatively compounded generator, and this is the characteristic curve graph. Okay, this series excitation aids the shunt excitation, and you know this compounding can be done at different degrees or different levels. Okay, there are different levels of compounding, so we'll discuss it right now. So coming to the degree of compounding, it depends upon the increase in series excitation with the increase in the load current. That is, if the series windings, okay, these turns, if the series turns are adjusted in such a way that this load current, if you see here, the series winding turns are so adjusted that with the increase in load current, the terminal voltage also increases. And this is what we call as the over-compounded generator. In this case, what happens is, as the load current increases, the series field MMF increases. And this tends to increase the flux. And as the flux is increasing, obviously, the terminal voltage will also increase. Right? In the sense, it generates the voltage. So the increase in generated voltage is greater than the IARA drop. We have learned what IARA drop is in the previous lecture. Here, if you see here, this is the IARA drop. We have learned it in the previous lecture, I remember. So what I was telling, yeah, the increase in generated voltage is greater than the IARA drop, and so that instead of decreasing, the terminal voltage increases. Okay, this is about the over compounded generator. See, if you see here, as the load current is increasing, the terminal voltage curve is increasing, the first curve, A curve. Okay, this is about the over compounded one. Now coming to the flat compounded generator. In this flat compounded generator, the series turns are adjusted in such a way that with the increasing load current, the terminal voltage is substantially constant. See, if you see here, with the increase in load current, the terminal voltage is almost same. It is ended, it is nearly close to this terminal voltage at full load. This dotted line, it depicts the terminal voltage at full load, right? Yeah. So the series winding of such a machine has lesser number of turns when compared to the over compounded one. Okay. So as this has less number of turns when compared to the over compounded one, the flux does not increase the flux as much as for a given load current. So consequently, the full load voltage is nearly equal to the no load voltage as shown here. So the third one, it is the over compounded generator. Here, the series field winding has lesser number of turns when compared to the flat compounded generator. So the terminal voltage falls with increase in the load current. See, as the load current is increasing, the terminal voltage is decreasing. The third curve, C curve. This is the under compounded generator. So what we have learnt is the series winding turns are in this order. Okay, the under compounded generator has less number of turns when compared to the flat, and which has less when compared to the over compounded generator. This is about the characteristics of DC generator. Now, the last part of our second chapter, that is applications of DC generators. There are limited applications for this DC generators. We will look what are they. First one, the separately excited DC generator. As you know, as we have learnt in this chapter, a separately excited DC generator requires an independent DC external source for the field winding, right? Okay, so thus it is costly and so it is rarely used. So the primary use is in the laboratory and for commercial testing and for speed regulation tests. The second one, that is series DC generator. As we have learned in this chapter, a series DC generator has limited applications. The rising characteristic of a series generator makes it suitable for for voltage boosting purposes. So it is used in boosters. That is, a series generator has the tendency to supply constant load current. Therefore, several series generators can be connected in series to provide high voltage DC power transmission at a constant current. Okay. Now the third one, shunt DC generators. A shunt DC generator essentially maintains constant terminal voltage. And therefore, since it maintains a constant terminal voltage, it is used for charging batteries. And shunt generators with field regulators are generally used for light and power supply purposes. The last one, it is the compound DC generator. Just now we have learnt about the over-compounded DC generator. So the over-compounded generators are used when where the generator is required to supply load via a long transmission line. See, okay, it is because over compounding compensates the voltage drop in the line, and this tends to maintain the constant voltage at the consumer's terminals. Okay, you got the point. So these four are the applications of DC generator. With this we have finished our second chapter, and you know, in this subject, to score well, you have to do problems also. The best way is, since you have learnt the theory part, the concept part, by watching this lecture series right now, now try solving one problem each from each model. From each model, try solving one problem, and that one, and this method will really help you, and you can score marks easily. Thank you.